Namaskar. Ladies and gentlemen, for certain technical reasons, we had to shift the venue of performance. And I know it's quite late in the evening, but I'm so happy and glad that all of you have assembled here to witness Kathak. In fact, Kathak is best enjoyed at this time after you have had a lovely dinner, and now there is no hurry except to go and relax to get ready for tomorrow. But this is the best time to sit and watch the classical art of North India. Many of you are aware, but still I take the pleasure and honor to say a few words about what Kathak is all about. Kathak, the very word Kathak comes from the root word katha, means story. Kathakar is a storyteller, and Kathak is the content, or sometimes even the performer is called as a Kathak. Very similar to some of the words we get like Kathika, Kahuga, all these words appear to us even in the Granthas of Ramayana and Mahabharata, where these storytellers would accompany the kings, accompany the soldiers, or just go on an excursion with these royalties and the noblemen and entertain. But whatever the entertainment were, they were predominantly spiritual in nature. Because for them, dance was an act of worship. Dance was an act of worship, and the body was used as an instrument of devotion. Hence, Kathak was always associated with spirituality until the art which was being practiced in the courtyards of the village or village central area, and when they were shifted to the temples to dedicate their art to the deities, presiding deities there. But it was when the kings and the noblemen invited these kathakars to their private halls and chambers and palaces, that is where the spiritual content and the technical virtuosity of the art form got equal emphasis. Then, when the Mongols, the Arab, and the Persian, they came to the this part of the continent and rooted the kingdom and the soils of India, it was inevitable that their Persian or the Islamic influence trickled into this holy art of the Hindus. Today, what you see is a beautiful blend of both Hinduism and Islam, bringing out the best of the spiritual ecstasy one feels while dancing and even when you're witnessing. But today, I would like to focus by bringing, or rather reviving, some of the repertoire which were danced in the temples and the court halls of the Hindu kings. I hope you will enjoy this show. We begin with a repertoire, a ode to Lord Shiva, because he is the cosmic dancer. And this composition is based on a very traditional old form of music called Dhruvapada. Phala Netra Harapinaki, which describes Lord Shiva and all his attributes. The poetry of this composition is just for the purpose when you listen to the various names of the Lord. It flashes in the various deeds and the power and the strength of that Lord, which strengthens us. Phala Netra Harapinaki.
Aangikam bhuvanam yasya va vachikam sarvavangmayam aharyam chandra taradi tam numaha sattvikam shivam tam numaha sattvikam shivam भस्मभूषिता आंगन शिव सिरपर गंगाधर सिरपर गंगाधर गले विराजे रुंडमाल गले विराज
will now present a technical dance number from the repertoire of Kathak in the court halls of the Hindu kings. Here, though the emphasis on the technical execution of the grammar of the dance, but towards the end, the artists are going to take out those basic elements that are essential or which forms the base of both music and dance. And this is concluded with a short footwork where the feet executes patterns, ringing a parallel or rather echoing the percussion instrument's composition. Prabhand.
ಕಿಟಕತ ಕಿಡಾನ ಧಾಧಾದಿಂದ ಕಿಟಕತ ಕಿಡಾನ ಧಾಧಾದಿಂದ ಕಿಟಕತ ಕಿಡಾನ ಕಿಟಕತ ಕಿಡಾನ ಕಿಟಕತ ಕಿಡಾನ ಧಾ.
As I mentioned, Indian classical dance or any dance art which raises to that level which stood the test of time, and many of these classical dances of India has its roots in this treatise of dramaturgy, which in itself more than 3,000 years old in this country, which has come down to us, most of it unchanged, but the spirit remains the same. The next number in that direction is once again an ode to that divine couple, Shiva and his consort Parvati. It's not the question of a gender difference of a male god and a female god. God is God, God is God, nothing. But it is the principles, it's the energies, that only when these two energy come together, we become a complete person. The best of the strength, the capability, the whatever you need to attain in the field of spirituality, it's only when these two powers come together. And to that couple of Shiva and Shakti, Nataraja and Parvati, the dancers offer their obeisance. This composition commences with a Sanskrit shloka written by Goswami Sri Tulsidas, then proceeds with selected two paragraphs from another Sanskrit composition called Vedasara Shivasthava, written by Sri Adi Shankaracharya, and concludes with a dance celebrating the virile dance of Lord Nataraja, the cosmic dancer, by a contemporary poet, Balwant Rai Bhatt. Bhavani Shankarau Vande Shraddha Vishwasa Rupinau Ya Gnana Vina Na Pashyanti Siddhantastamishwaram.
Smarami, smarami, Mahadeva mekam, smarami, smarami.
ஆரா